The Prajwal Revana videos, as they're infamously called now, have been floating around online since at least April 22nd. The women in these sexually explicit videos have been subjected to stigma and ostracization, and quite obviously have been extremely distressed. While most politicians have gone on endlessly blaming one another, hatching political conspiracies, there's been no word of sympathy for the women. Karnataka Civil Society has stepped up and has extended support to these women. The group that has called itself Navedu Nilladidare has a message to the women and the society at large. My colleague Anisha, who's joining me now, is going to tell us some of the important points that they've made in this open letter that they've written both to the women and the society at large.
The letter that we're talking about addresses some of these questions. It is addressed to dear sisters and fellow citizens, and it highlights that the perpetrators belong to a very powerful family. It says, those who've been assaulted should not harbor any shame or guilt for the crimes that were perpetrated on them. Society too should not condemn them and view them as criminals. In fact, it is those who perpetrated these atrocities, hid them in shameful silence, and others who exposed and used them for their own political ends who should hang their heads in shame.
Let's remember, these videos contain visuals of women being sexually assaulted, and some others contain women performing sexual acts. Now, because of the nature of these videos and how it was distributed, many people mistake some of them as consensual acts. The letter also addresses this point. Anisha, what does it say about this particular aspect?
To those who say that some acts were consensual, we say, consent is a cruel joke in a society that objectifies women and requires them to be subjected to the whims and demands of powerful men around them in order to survive. Even if they have exercised their consent in this limited understanding, they would surely not have consented to having their lives disseminated for all to consume in the midst of this vicious political battle of men in power.
Why this letter is so important is because for the last 1.5 months, the conversation has been so much around just the politics of it all. Will Prajwal Revana come back? Yes, that's a very important aspect of this. But let's not forget that there are lives, hundreds of them, in the center of this entire controversy. And this letter explains what happens, you know, once the cameras move away, once the press goes away, because they have their own families to answer to, their society as well, that they are every day living in, right? So Anisha, let's look at what else they say in the letter, because so far 3 women have come forth and filed complaints, but there could be more. There could be other women who want to come ahead and file the complaints, but for some reason or the other, they have not been able to. Tell us, read out those parts of the letter that addresses this issue.
Towards the end of the letter, the civil society group called for action. They called upon the women to file complaints and they called upon society to stand by them. They said, come, dear sisters, shrug off the shame that you're being made to feel. Don't bear the burden of the wrongs done to you. Come out, boldly speak up and register your complaint. Fellow citizens, let's firmly stand with them till justice is done by a system that has allowed this crime to happen. We want to reassure our sisters that there are many who believe without a doubt that dignity is your birthright and ours, the birthright of all women. We are with you. Come and join us. So while they acknowledge that it is not easy to file complaints, they also urge society to stand by them because of the difficulty in filing complaints. So they say that it's not easy for the women to actually come out of their homes, their fears and threats and pressures to take on these powerful men who have assaulted and exploited them. Which is why it is important that families, neighbors, and relatives stand strongly in support of them.
We've been covering this entire issue of the Prajwal Revana videos for the last 1.5 months. My colleague Anisha, along with Shivani and Nandini, made multiple trips to Hassan. And we've tried to be as sensitive and responsible in our coverage. If you like what we do, if you appreciate our journalism, then consider becoming a paid TNM subscriber. And also, if you want to support reporters like Anisha, then you can contribute to our reporting fund. Thank you for watching.